Hey guys, this is AC Service Tech, and today what we're going over is the fast and easy way to blow out a condensate line for an air conditioning system. So a way that you could do it real quickly is just with a 20-cent piece of vinyl tubing with some electrical tape on the side. Basically, you're just increasing the outside diameter. We're going to take our tee off and we're going to push this down inside of here. So past where it drains in at, so you make sure that you're down in here. Just to show you, basically you want to increase the size, the outer size, just to make sure that it fits inside of the tubing, but you don't want it like this, because then when you push your air in, it can go around it instead of blowing any gunk out that you have in the trap. Something else that you could use instead is compressed air, and you could have an extension that threads in here, or you could use a piece of 3/8 OD copper, and then you just wrap electrical tape on the end in order to increase the outside diameter. So you could use compressed air or nitrogen, like a fitting like this. Make sure that you don't use any higher than 30 psi on your nitrogen regulator or your compressed air regulator. You don't want to end up blowing apart the condensate lines. Some people out there don't use the primer on here, and they just glue the fittings together, and you don't want to end up accidentally blowing them apart. I also wouldn't use this either, because when you push it down into here, air can go this way or this way. So I always want to make sure that I'm getting down into the trap. It doesn't hurt for the air to go this way. I just want to make sure that we do clean the trap out. You could have a little bit of gunk over here as well. That could be clogging it up, but most of the time it's just in the trap. So regardless of the way that you blow this out, you first have to fill it with some water. So if this is a preventative maintenance, it's probably dry. So you want to just go ahead and put a little water in it. Then we're going to take our compressed air, we're going to put this down inside. I'm going to hold the top just to make sure that water doesn't splash out of it. I'll do that a second time as well. I like to put just a little bit more water in the trap, and then I'm going to blow it through again. When you're done, you want to make sure that you fill the trap back up with water, so that the system will drain the condensate correctly. If that trap is dry, in the case of an air handler, it's going to end up sucking air through the condensate line. If it's on an evaporator coil after a furnace, then the airflow would end up going through the tubing. So the weight of the water that's in here stops the airflow from traveling through the pipe, and it allows the condensate to just drain freely. Also, make sure that you put your cap back on afterwards. Once again, if you don't have compressed air or nitrogen, you can just make something simple. You can put that into there and then just blow. And you might want to do that 2 or 3 times, and basically that will end up unclogging that trap. I also highly recommend having the safety switch installed in the secondary drain port of the pan, just to make sure that if there is some type of problem with water backing up inside the pan, this switch right here will stop the outdoor condensing unit from running to make sure that no damage occurs. If you want to help support this HVACR training channel, check out patreon.com/acservicetech. And if you're looking for the tools that I use out in the field, I have them all linked down in the comment section and description section below. Hope you enjoyed yourself, and we'll see you next time at AC Service Tech channel.